Hello everyone. In this demo, I'll walk you through how an engineer can utilize Ansys Engineering Copilot for simulation. This is an electric box enclosure. There are two bodies, both assigned with plastic material. The lid is fastened to the box using preloaded bolts at the four corners. The preloading will slightly deform the lid, which causes small gaps in between. The goal of the simulation is to examine the effects of nonlinear contact in modal analysis. As a new user of mechanical, I've had some previous experience with linear static structural, but nonlinear contact and bolt pretension are both new to me. To get familiar with these new topics, let me first go to Learning and Support tab and launch Engineering Copilot. I'll start with bolt pretension first, which I have no clue about the proper ways of modeling it. So let me first ask Ansys GPT to get some pointers. I put in the question, what are the methods of simulating bolt pretension in mechanical? Ansys GPT immediately gave me a nice summary of different options of simulating bolts and pointed me to the reference links. From the summary and the help documentation it pointed to, I understand that I can either have the bolt geometry modeled as a 3D geometry or line bodies, or if I don't have the geometry for bolts, I can simply use the beam connection, which is perfect for my case. As I never used beam connection before, I'll first do a wider search in the Home tab across the AIS platform. With the keyword beam connection and the bolts, this search returned some useful resources from help documentation, AIS courses, and a forum discussion. For example, if I follow this connecting bolts represented as beam connection, a beam elements, it brings me to this course, which provided me a step-by-step instruction. Now coming back to mechanical, right-click on connections and insert a beam connection. Put in the radius, scope to the reference side on the lid, and a mobile side on the box. And I have one beam connection created. I have three more to go, which is okay, but what if I have tens or hundreds of samples to create for some other cases? I wonder if there is a simpler way to create bolts automatically. I'll do a search again in the Home tab with the keyword create multiple beam connections. This search points me to a feature called Object Generator, and let's give that a try. Go to the Automation tab, launch Object Generator, and the beam connection has already been selected from the tree for me. I'll make use of the predefined name sections to scope it to the reference mobile side, put in the range for the beam length, make sure to check this box to avoid duplicates, put in a prefix for my name, and click on generate. You can see that the three beam connections for the other locations have been automatically created for me. With that, I'm ready for the next step to define bolt pretension. But first, I wanted to see if there's any courses to help me understand the theories and setup. So let me do a search in the Learning tab. With the keyword bolt, it returned me a list of courses that I can go through. If I click on one of them, it will launch a small window right next to mechanical. From there, I can easily enroll to the course, go through the handouts and examples. Following what I learned from the course and other materials, I'll go back to mechanical, drag and drop the beam connections into static structural. Select all the bolt pretension definitions, go to the first load step, define a preload, and then go to the second load step and define locking step. Now the bolts are defined, my next step is to set up frictional contact, which is a type of nonlinear contact. I can search again in the learning for nonlinear content. This will direct me to a good course that walks me through the contact technology and its setup in mechanical. I can follow this course to set up a nonlinear contact and also my boundary conditions to finish the setup of the model. Now all the model setups are done and it's ready to solve. This will take a minute or two. After the solve completes, I can look at the results. For example, total deformation or stress results. One important thing I'd like to check is the behavior of nonlinear contact, but I don't know how. I recall that during my previous interaction with Ansys support team, I asked the question how to extract a contact result, but now I forgot the settings. I'd like to review that support case. In the past, I'll have to leave Mechanical and log in to ACSS to review my support cases. Now with the Engineering Copilot, I can simply go to the support tab and browse to the case I was looking for. Now I have found this case, let me click into it. This brings up all the interactions, it's recorded, and it shows up here. From where I know I need to right click from a solution and insert a contact tool. Once evaluate the status, I can see from the plot that near the boats, most of the regions are sticking or closed. And there are some other locations are shown as open or near open status. Now the static solution is complete and I'm ready to move on to the modal analysis. In the pre-stress setting, notice that there is a contact status setup, which I don't quite understand. To see if there's any explanation for this specific setting, I can go to the Knowledge tab to search for knowledge materials. With the keyword nonlinear contact modal, I found this FAQ that summarized the effect of different contact status setup. In my case, I'll leave it as true status, which is the default. Now the modal analysis is soft. Let's take a look at the force mode shape and play the animation. If you zoom in, you can see that it has maintained the calculated true status from static base analysis, which is expected. This completes the demo. Thank you for watching.